Hey everybody, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I'm your favorite developer advocate, Olivia, with the TomTom Apps APIs, and today I'm going to be walking you through a remake of one of our most loved introductions, and it's going to be adding a map to your website in 2 minutes or less, so start your timers and keep watching. So, add a map to your website in 2 minutes. Okay, with the timer on, let's create an empty HTML file. I know it has a head section, and it has a body section, and inside the body section we have a div that will hold the map. And in this div we have an ID, let's call it as usual map. I'm going to next add some styling, so let's see, width of 100% and a height of also 100%. Now we know we need a script section, and of course a style is JavaScript, and now we have that all set here. In the head section, I will add the link to the CSS style sheet from the developer portal, and I'll add that reference later. And finally, we have the SDK for web. The type is, of course, JavaScript. I'm leaving the SRC value empty for now as well. Now I need to go to the developer portal to check the latest version and get the URL for this SDK and the CSS style sheet. So, documentation, web SDK, downloads, and scroll to the requisites. I see the URL of the CSS file here. Let's paste it in the document. And then we have the SDK source here. Okay, let's go to the script. First, I'll set a variable where the map will be centered. Let's center equal, set this to a random location. Let's pick 4. I think that 4 is a lucky number. And the array order is longitude and latitude. And then we'll need the map instance, which will be a tt.map, and it has options as parameters. We know that the first option is usually the key, the API key that you can get for free in our developer portal, but now I'm adding the one that we have been using in our videos. And we need to specify the container, and the container is called map and matches this ID. And we want to correct that name. The center is the center variable, and the zoom, let's add that a bit farther away. Add a marker, right? We start with tt.marker, standard marker, set the longitude and latitude location, and look at that, it auto-completed, so that's no problem. I want to set the value to only center, since the order is already correct. And then we'll finally edit to the map. I think we're done. Let's stop the counter and check on how it looks. So now let's start our HTTP server, and let's go to the browser. And we can see a map. Of course, I imagine you won't have a full map in your website, and so probably it's going to be inserted between other elements, so let's make it a little smaller. We can change the width to 40% of the viewport width, and fix the height to 350 pixels. And these are just some example values. And now we'll go back to the browser and reload, and voila! And that is how you add a map in your website. If you want to make your own custom marker, check out this video here.
We hope you liked that tutorial, and I hope you stopped your timers to make sure we fit it into the 2 minutes that we promised. Give us a like, a comment, a subscribe even, and maybe go to our developer portal, check out the documentation on any topics that we covered in the video, and ask us a question on our dev forum. And better yet, happy mapping!